रेडियो 106.3 FM अनिरुद्ध आपके साथ। गुड मॉर्निंग, द शो इज कॉल्ड रेड कार्पेट। 10 से 11 के बीच में हर शनिवार रेड कार्पेट पर हम लोग बात करते हैं सक्सेसफुल एक्सपैट्स, कतरीज, बिजनेसमैन, स्पोर्ट्स लीडर्स, थॉट लीडर्स और ऐसे आर्टिस्ट से जिनसे आपको बहुत कुछ सीखने मिलेगा। आज हमारे साथ गेस्ट एविस विश्वनाथन। एविस इज द हैप्पीनेस वाला। ये एक लाइफ कोच है, इंस्पायर्ड स्पीकर है एंड ही इज एन ऑथर एज वेल हु लीड्स चेंज मैनेजमेंट मैंडेट्स ग्लोबली। Avis, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Aniruddha. It's wonderful to be on this show. Thank you so much.
Lovely. Acha, in the past, Avis has been ranked among the top 10 motivational speakers in India by the Week magazine as well. Avis aur unki wife Vaani ke baare mein bahut sari baatein aapko batani hain. Unse bhi janenge unki family ke baare mein and what he's been up to. Show abhi shuru hai. Baatein bahut sari karni hain. Let's begin. Avis, you call yourself the happiness wala. So, what's the story behind the happiness wala? Throw some light on what you and Vaani together do these days.
I'm delighted to be on the show. Let me introduce myself and the concept of happiness wala to you. Life that Vaani and I have been leading for the past decade has completely changed the way we look at life itself. Mm-hmm. So we were running a consulting firm that went bankrupt in 2007.
Right.
And plunged me and my wife and our two children, our family, into complete worthlessness and pennilessness. So at one time, we had everything going for us. And around the time that my children were teenagers, we had everything material snatched away from us.
Right.
And that experience of the bankruptcy could have pushed us into depression and despair. But what it did was it opened our eyes and our hearts and our souls to a great opportunity, which is the opportunity to be happy despite our circumstances. And when I say happy, I am talking about the art of being non-worrying,
right,
non-frustrated and non-suffering. When you have nothing material, jab aapke paas paisa nahi hota hai, kaam nahi hota hai, so your worries can chew you up.
But
Vaani helped me along and I learned the art of being non-worrying.
Yeah.
When you make every effort to put your business on track,
right,
and it doesn't come good, then you become frustrated. But we learn to be non-frustrated. Through the bankruptcy, we discovered this art of being happy.
Lovely.
Despite our circumstances. And that's why we said, hey, we are not bankrupt as people. Business is bankrupt. The situation is of a bankruptcy.
Correct.
But we are the happiness wala.
Correct.
That's why I call myself the happiness wala.
Yeah, lovely, lovely. You need not worry when you don't have anything to lose. So that's the best thing.
In a way, yes. See, problems come in two forms.
Yeah.
One is they fall under two buckets. One is a problem that you can solve.
Yeah.
Okay. If you can solve a problem, why worry?
Yeah, okay? True that.
And if you can't solve a problem, that's the second category of problems. When you can't solve a problem, why worry? So bottom line, worrying is a complete waste.
Absolutely.
So we learned the art of being non-worrying.
Beautiful.
And that's a key contributor to being happy in life.
Absolutely. Beautiful. So Avis, you know, now the question is, you've been through a lot. You've struggled with the bankruptcy part. Your family has endured with you. That's absolutely amazing. You know, what else can help you apart from your family? People either are two types, you know, either they look into the past and then, you know, they frame their strategy of moving ahead in life as per their history, or people don't care. You know, the other type of people, they don't look into the past. They just keep moving on. What kind of person are you? Do you look into the past or you keep moving ahead?
I used to be a person who was completely trapped in the throes of anger with myself over choices I had made in my life with regard to the business. My wife had many times, Vaani, told me, don't do certain things, and I went ahead and did them. So I was trapped in anger, grief, guilt, and all the negative, debilitating emotions that you can think of. Yes, I used to hold on to the past and cry a lot. But the process of enduring the bankruptcy led me to a daily practice of observing an hour's silence.
Right.
So I would sit quietly. It was more like an inner quest. And I would sit quietly every day and think about my thoughts.
Okay.
That process taught me a very important learning in life, which is that by thinking about your past, by worrying about it, by grieving about it, by being angry about it, you cannot solve your problems.
Yeah.
And by worrying about your future, the unborn future, by fearing it.
Right.
When जब आपके पास पैसा नहीं होता है और काम नहीं होता है और बच्चे जवान हो रहे हैं आपको you know कुछ उनके लिए करना पड़ेगा आपको अपने कर्जदारों को पैसा लौटाना पड़ेगा you want to come back clean into the world
right
then you are gripped with fear and insecurity about the future
right
I discovered that both these states are a complete waste the past which is the dead past and the future which is the unborn future
right
so I learned the art of being in the moment that's why we are called human beings be in the moment
yeah beautiful
and in the moment
beautiful
in the moment you can only be happy
So true. Avis, Fall Like a Rose Petal. Tell me more about the title and the book.
Oh, that's an interesting question, Aniruddha. Fall Like a Rose Petal is a set of letters that I wrote to my two children. They're named Ashirvad and Anchal.
Okay.
So I wrote letters to my two children through the nights of our bankruptcy. You know, I started my career as a journalist. I'm a writer intuitively. So I knew when things went down to the wire and we were hanging at the edge of a precipice.
Right.
You know, on 31st December 2007, we found ourselves with just 2,000 rupees in our hand. Just 2,000 Indian rupees in our hand.
Okay.
And 5 crore rupees in debt. $1 million at that time to be repaid in debt and absolutely no other assets with us. And no work. And that's when I told myself, and I told Vaani that I'm going to write about this experience. And I started writing these letters to my two children. I never shared it with them. My daughter at that time was 13. My son was 18. And I said they're a little too young to deal with life's realities. So I started writing these letters to them, but kept them in my Word document on my laptop.
Right.
When my son turned 21 in 2011, I gave him a copy of the Word file and told him, Ash, take a look at this. And he said, Appa, this must be a book.
Right.
And I laughed it off and I said, hey, I can't do a book. You know, I never thought I would write a book like this. And who would want to read the story of a father who's bankrupt, sharing his innermost feelings with his family? But both Vaani and Ashirvad prevailed on me. And eventually in 2014, the book came out.
Beautiful.
We decided to call it Fall Like a Rose Petal because it's inspired by a story, a Sufi story, that Osho used to tell his followers. And the story itself is of a Sufi master.
Okay.
He used to ask his disciples, have you seen a rose petal fall? Jab gulab ka petal jo hai, jab apna kaam when it finishes its job of blooming as part of the rose bud,
right.
It falls unquestioningly in a graveyard, in a place of worship, on a newly married couple,
beautiful.
Or it could be on the street,
beautiful.
And be crushed by a passing vehicle.
Yeah.
Petal does not question why it is falling or where it is going to be taken by life.
True.
So the Sufi master says, why can't we human beings be like that? And so, Fall Like a Rose Petal is a set of letters that I wrote to Ashirvad and Anchal. And it's a father's lesson on how to be happy and content while living without money. So that's the story of the book and the title.
Absolutely beautiful. Lovely. Avis, in fact, you know, there's so much to speak to you. You know, we need to be decisive in life. We need to take decisions every other moment. And there's always uncertainty, you know, because decisions change the way we lead our lives. They change the path that we walk on later on in life. About being decisive, people who are sometimes, you know, they're not sure about what to do in life. Something for them?
I would say don't postpone happiness. That's the key decision-making point.
Right.
Agar aap ki अंदर की आवाज आपकी इनर वॉइस इज वांटिंग टू डू समथिंग एल्स बट यू आर बीइंग प्रेशराइज्ड बाय योर रियल वर्ल्ड कंडीशंस टू डू समथिंग एल्स
राइट
listen to your inner voice.
Yeah.
Don't postpone your happiness because life is a limited period offer.
Yeah.
Ye bahut jaldi tamam hone wali hai aapki zindagi.
Yeah, true.
So before it expires, live it fully.
Hmm.
In whatever condition you are, it's not the material wealth or the material ecosystem. You need to think of your inner ecosystem.
Yeah.
And therefore, I have based all my decisions once I came to this phase of dealing with the bankruptcy. I based all my decisions on what makes me intrinsically calm, peaceful, and happy.
Beautiful.
And I can tell you, when you heed your inner voice, it will never lead you astray. Those are not exactly my words. Those are Rumi's words. So I firmly believe in those words. You know, listen to the inner voice. It can never lead you astray.
Beautiful. And now let's find out about Avis and his wife Vaani. So how has the partnership been with Vaani now?
I'll tell you, I proposed to Vaani when I was 19 and she was 20. It was under a rain screen in Chennai that I proposed to her on a half moon night.
Oh, beautiful.
And for the longest time I thought wo meri zindagi ka sabse romantic lamha tha.
Right.
And then on 31st December 2007, when we realized we were bankrupt, we realized we had only those 2000 rupees in my hand. Imagine hamare haath mein sirf 2000 rupees hain aur kuch nahi aur dher sara karza hai hamare samne aur do jawan bacche hain aur Vaani wahan baithi hui hai, and I'm going to Vaani and I'm saying, I call her mom. I say, mom, I'm so sorry that we reached this stage in our life. I don't know how far we have to go or how long this will take, but I will be very grateful if you can walk alongside me. She looked at me in my eyes, reached forward for my arms, held my hand and said, Dad, and she calls me Dad, said, Dad, I have walked with you all our life, and I will walk with you forever. However long this takes and however far we have to go, I will walk with you.
Beautiful.
I tell you, that night, that moment replaced the moment of 1988.
Yeah.
And that moment became the most romantic moment of my life. And towards the last 10 years, Vaani and I have been literally walking alongside each other, heart me heart diye, wading through this very, very difficult situation. And I would not have made it without her support.
Beautiful.
We're still far, far away from returning all our debt. Our business has not picked up phenomenally. There are some signs here and there, but it hasn't picked up at all in terms of being able to retire our debt.
Right.
But without her support alongside me, I would not be where I am today. So it's a fantastic partnership. And both of us know that isme running between the wickets ki rhythm jo hai, wo hame dono barkarar rakhni hai. Aur ek ballebaaz janta hai ki agar dusra nahi hoga kisi karanvash aage chal ke, to the other one will take care of getting us through the last mile.
Avis, someone's inspired and they want to follow your thought process and your life lessons. How can someone follow you on social media, and if you could give your website address as well?
So I'm on all forms of social media. I'm on Instagram as the happynesswala, happiness spelled with a Y, happynesswala, the happynesswala. That's my handle. On Twitter, I am at Avis Viswanathan, and then my blog is there where I share life lessons almost every day. I used to write every day for about 10 years. But I've taken a break from writing every day. But I do share life lessons on my blog, which is on WordPress, avisviswanathan.wordpress.com. And Viswanathan is V-I-S-W-A-N-A-T-H-A-N.
All right. Lovely. Avis, thank you so much for spending your time. And it was a pleasure speaking to you. Hoping to see you very, very soon next time I'm in India.
Sure. Looking forward, Aniruddha. Thank you for the call.
Red carpet par aaj bas itna hi. Next time we're going to catch up again next Saturday, 10 to 11. Don't forget, sirf Radio Olive 106.3 FM par. Jio Bindas. Goodbye. Take care.